Welcome behind the scenes of our recent photo shoot, Film Noir. Hey guys, my name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. Today we're going to take a look behind the scenes at Film Noir, a recent series, and we're going to talk a little bit about our lighting, some of the problems we overcame, the ideas about creating an entire series together, and a little bit of the post-production. So your job as a photographer, for the most part, is to create a way for your viewers to get into the photos you take. And including emotion is a great way to do it because your viewer will see emotion in the photograph and they'll feel it in themselves, and that kind of creates that connection. Another great way to do it is with a series of images. And it's no coincidence that a lot of the photos you see picked up on the internet and blogs are a part of a series because it gives multiple reference points for a person to see, like, okay, this image relates to that image, relates to that image, relates to that image, and it makes everything kind of come together and feel a little bit more comfortable to the viewer who's looking at it as opposed to a standalone. Now, production on a series like this is huge. We shot for 14 hours, we had 6 different locations, we rented a van, a fog machine, and a generator, all those from different places. We had 3 models, we had a hairstylist, a wardrobe stylist, and a makeup artist. We had 2 behind the scenes shooters, a first assistant, me as a photographer, and all of it came together great, and I couldn't have done any of it alone. So the first location we shot at was a bar, and this is a great location because bars, for the most part, are closed during the day. So you can shoot during the day and they can still open up for business at night. Now, one of the challenges was the lighting just really wasn't that great during the day. They're kind of built to look good at night. So we had to create our own lighting from scratch. And to do that, we used a softbox kind of coming in from the outside, which made it look like a little bit later in the day with that light coming through. We also used a couple parabolic reflectors to bring up the overall ambient in the bar. And we used a spotlight on the back left corner of the image with a CTO gel on it to kind of give the image a little bit of a rim and a little bit more interest with that extra color in there. The bar was great because it had a lounge downstairs, and we used that for our second location, which we wanted to be the seduction shot. Now, we work with models for the most part, not necessarily actors, but we do ask our models to kind of act things out. They don't have to talk, they don't have lines, but in this case, for instance, we had them kind of come through the door on the left and actually, like, you know, pretend to be making out and things like that as they walked over and got on the couch. So we were taking photographs of this whole process, and what happens is, you know, everything tends to be a lot more natural rather than just telling a person to pose in a certain way. We can capture that actual movement as it's happening. To replicate natural lighting in this lounge environment, there was a lamp off to the camera right. So we placed another light off to the side of that with a CTO gel, and that was shining back into our subjects. So it looks like the lamp is actually lighting all of our subjects, when in reality, for the most part, it's that other light. We also used a couple parabolics back behind the models, also gelled a little warm to fill in that light. Now, you can't have a Film Noir series without a graveyard. So we found a great graveyard to shoot in. We got a couple props that are really important for this series. One of us is a 1964 Thunderbird. We also rented a generator and a fog machine, and this was off to the camera left. We basically had the generator and the fog machine going for the entire shot, which generated a ton of fog and drifted on through the set. So it was a completely clear day. All the fog was created by the fog machine. Now, the fog machine also helped to kind of catch the light beams of the car, so you could see the light beams actually in the fog. We also used lights off to the camera left, which were gelled the same color as the car lights, to make it look like the car lights were lighting our subjects as well. Now, the right side would have been completely dark with our subjects because, again, it's getting a little bit late. So we used a parabolic reflector off to the camera right, this one without a gel, so it's gonna be a little bit cooler in temperature, and that would imitate the light that's actually going on in the ambient environment. Since we got such an awesome car, we had to do some photographs in the car, and we photographed both of the girls and we photographed the guy as well. So kind of the story of the guy was photographed before the graveyard event happened and the girls were photographed after the graveyard happened. With the girl shot, again, we had the light coming in from the camera right, and that was gelled a quarter CTO, and that's basically like looking as though it was bouncing off something, what was going on with the headlights of the car. And then off to the left, we have a red gelled strobe, and that's looking like something going on with the taillights. We also have another light in the back, and that's actually the rental van that we got for the shop. We thought it might be interesting if it looked like there was another car behind this car as well. So straight up rental van, but you can't really tell, it's a little bit out of focus, and that's one of the cool parts of the shot. Shooting on a fire escape was probably logistically the hardest shot I've ever done. Our subject was three stories up outside on a freezing cold windy Chicago night, and we had to light this shot. So all the light you see in this image is completely fake, none of it is real. The main light is coming from the top, and that's a strobe that's actually on a grate right above her, and that's gelled CTO as well. We have another light that's boomed 18 feet up, camera left, and that's got a CTO gel as well, and that's what's carving some detail there in her face. And then we have another light that's behind the camera, camera right, and that has no gel on it, and that's kind of looking like maybe a different street light with a different color temperature on it. So we're lighting a subject, you know, with these huge lights boomed up in the air, and she's three stories up. To create a little bit more interest, we also used a fog machine. Now the fog machine was down on the ground and we generated fog right in this kind of corner here, and it kind of spiraled up into the shot. So, you know, as you can imagine, I'm standing on the ground there with my camera pointing straight up, and we've got fog spiraling up, and she's kind of standing over there in the windy dress. Everyone on the shoot is afraid of heights, including me. So we were all freaking out, but the shot came out amazing and we're so happy we did it. So it all just kind of came together for this one moment, and sometimes you just have to take a chance. So even if you have a crazy idea like shooting outside in a fire escape at night, pull it off, because you never know, that might be your favorite shot. The same building with the fire escape had these amazing old elevators with those doors that kind of like pull out accordion style. So we decided to use that as a makeshift cuculoris, which mostly I just wanted to say that word, but it's when you put something, you know, between your light and your background, and it kind of creates some shadows and patterns with your light. So all the shadows in the background you see here are actually created by the door, and having that light shine out in between those creates that really interesting pattern. We also had a light inside of the elevator, which was a little bit warmer. So the light combined with the warm light and the cool light from outside brought together these portraits to make them super dramatic and very cool, while adding that extra little bit of interest in with those shadows. Bringing it all together in post was really important and a huge part of making the film noir series, because we wanted to make sure that they all kind of tied in together to tell a story. And film noir, you're gonna get a lot of like blues and greens and the shadows, yellows and reds and the highlights. So all these images, after been editing, have been color toned as well, and all of them kind of like brought together to match each other in style. Thanks for joining us on our journey through film noir. I hope you guys enjoy the images and a behind the scenes look at how the images were actually made. We look for a tutorial coming soon. Thanks again, guys, and I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone.